The first serial aircraft amphibian LAH is taking off from Volga River not far from Samara city center. The path of any aircraft from a drawing to a serial aircraft takes many years, but it's really thorny when you have to create design department and aircraft factory before the beginning of the design work. It's just that very case with LA-8.
I got the idea of LA-8 in about 2000, when I used to fly for hunting and fishing with my friends. We flew then aboard my own Yak-40, but on arriving in Naryan-Mar or Vorkuta or Norilsk, we had to change from the plane to the helicopter Mi-8, which we had to order in advance, and wait. And we flew farther on aboard the helicopter. The journey was quite troublesome and took much time. And I got the idea of purchasing an amphibian aircraft. I started to survey the world market. It took much time, about 2 years, but I did not find anything that would be suitable on dimensions and easy to operate. In Samara, where I was born, some small self-made amphibians were being built. I established the enterprise in 2002. We hired workers and designers, and I developed the requirements specifications. Thus, the idea of this aircraft was founded.
И я сделал техническое задание, как бы заложил сюжет или идею этого самолета.
The Samara Enterprise Aero Volga is a producer of modern light hydroplanes. The first prototype of LA-8 took off in 2004. Then the aircraft was manufactured by Peace, and quite recently it's been managed to set the serial production of these two-engine aircraft amphibians. Let's look in the workshops of Aero Volga to see visually the difference between the serial and the Peace production of the aircraft. Assembly workshop. The workers are installing the equipment on the first serial aircraft. While the aircraft, as it's said in aviation, is unhatched, you can see how it's satiated with systems. On our first question, if there is anything unnecessary here, we have got the intelligible answer.
This is our position. We save weight on minor construction elements, but we don't just throw them out, but we convert them in load-bearing elements. This is our policy.
The main components of the aircraft reliability are structural strength and fail safety of units and systems. If consider, the aircraft builders sell just these features packed in the aircraft. And this packaging begins in design department. Just the right technical specification will be the exact result which will be sold to the customer.
If you look attentively at the LA-8, you'll see that the major load-bearing elements are duplicated and some of them even triplicated. The force is transferred parallel by several elements. At the same time, the rest elements are meant for that one of the elements is destroyed. Indeed, load-carrying capacity is limited, but it still remains.
Converting the piece production of the aircraft into serial production, designers inevitably conclude that it's necessary to comply with the airworthiness regulations, otherwise it will be the next homemade product. Any details make sense.
We use only those key elements that have type certificates. At the same time, we work with OEM contracts. It's very important as well, because experience shows that the properly developed technical specification of both components is guarantee of your reliability.
To turn the workshop into serial factory, the management of Aero Volga had to divide production on technological sections and arrange their cooperation, because quality and reliability are defined by culture of production, and it's not available without system of control.
On each section where some details or units of the aircraft are manufactured, they pass through such control. Firstly, they are checked by worker by himself. Secondly, they are checked by foreman of the section. Thirdly, it's control of employees of the technical inspection department. Their functions are conducted by our designers. While passing detail from one section to another, encounter control is performed.
The real serial factory risen up in bare field literally. How is it possible? It was helped by understanding of the fact that the production of light aircraft should be not great, and it has to be started from nothing.
Мы верили, что это возможно, и это возможно именно с нашими людьми.
We believed that it was possible, and it is possible just with our people in our Russian conditions. Saying that all is easy will not be true. We work hard, but we work to have a future. And we think that if people in Russia will believe in that is possible instead of impossible, we can manufacture products of world class, world level, and work up the world markets.
Russians would not be Russians if they would not plan anything global. The success of LA-8 production has been the result of the following. The group of pilots with support of Aerovolga organizes the round-the-world flight. The real flight, above the oceans and the seas of the Earth.
The idea of the flight occurred very long ago, not yesterday. It happened this way. My friend Valery Tokarev, hero of the Russian Federation, pilot cosmonaut, worked aboard the International Space Station, and he performed great work referring to ocean research from the station. Once he called me on mobile from the station and said, "Listen, Sergei, I'm doing some really great and interesting work here, but I see all the information from above, but I look at the oceans and I really want to fly above the water and touch it with my hands. Let's do it on your aircraft, LA-8. And then we had a burning desire and began to develop the route. There were enthusiasts who were ready to join us, and now they are ready for this event.
The presentation of the round-the-world flight 20,000 leagues above the sea took place in summer. The new serial amphibian aircraft LA-8 was not as hero of the presentation as it was the point of attraction for the guests. The wing of exactly the same aircraft served as a bracket for a screen on which guests saw the concept of the round-the-world flight as it was previously developed.
Предусматривается, что все следующее лето будет посвящено...
We are planning that next summer the crews will prepare for this flight as well on the long routes. We want to fly behind the Arctic Circle to Novaya Zemlya. We want to fly along the Trans-Siberian Railway from Moscow to Vladivostok and back to check the aircraft, check ourselves, and to prepare for quite a serious journey around the Earth. Because no one before us has flown so that in one round-the-world journey to pass all the continents oceans, including the Arctic Ocean and Antarctica. So all this in one flight.
A specifically updated, radically modernized LA-8 aircraft, which has been built now in full swing, has to get over three oceans and a lot of seas.
Просчитав маршрут, мы поняли, что на серийной машине, которую производит мой завод, на ЛА-8, мы никак...
When we calculated the route, we understood that we could not implement the set task using the serial LA manufactured by my factory if we failed to convert it into a flying tanker. But we would like to have standard serial aircraft without special additional fuel tanks, which could land on the ocean without any problems. So that, having worked with our design department, we decided that we would have to make the new modification, which would allow to get over a large distance above the seas, up to 3,000 kilometers, without fear, and could land on the open sea, because on the route we intend to land on the ocean and on uninhabited areas as well.
The guests of the presentation, one following the other, try the cockpit for its comfortability in long-duration flight. The route of the flight is planned over many seaside countries. So the flight will be long.
Many people undertook round-the-world journeys, but probably no one flew over all countries at once.
The main purpose of the flight to pass along the world coast and cross the Atlantic and Pacific Oceans to visit the Arctic Ocean and Antarctica.
We have to arrive in Antarctica at the end of October, approximately, not earlier, because it will be still cold there. In order we can land, the temperature conditions must be more favorable. We've planned two landings there, one on the Bellingshausen station. There's a suitable unpaved aerodrome there. The second landing we planned should be on South Georgia Island, where there is no aerodrome, so we'll have to land in bay, and the air temperature should be above zero, otherwise we won't be able to take off afterwards.
Under the advanced estimation, the whole flight will take 330 hours, but much depends on weather conditions. In some places, pilots and navigators will have real difficulties. Tropical heat and strongest cyclones are the main concerns. The landings are planned on the uninhabited atolls where the local flora and fauna have never seen the aircraft.
Наиболее сложными этапами по-прежнему остаются это пересечение морских акваторий и, в частности, двух
океанов. The most difficult stages will be crossing the waters of the Pacific and Atlantic Oceans. The most difficult stage will be the Pacific Ocean. We are going to fly over the islands that are almost uninhabited. Some of them are flooded or submerged and almost unseen from above. There will be the most difficult stages, probably.
Вот это, наверное, будет самый сложный этап.
The other unusual feature of planned flight is its scientific program. It's planned to take sample of water to research biology of the world ocean.
Изучение морей, океанов, прибрежных вод там это не только
Sea, ocean and coastal waters research is not just a speculative mission when we admire the beauties of nature. We must understand where and what quantity of plankton is concentrated. This is just pertaining to the national economy problems, taking samples, the state of ecology and its tendency in the coastal waters.
It's not a secret that in some countries of the world, Russia is considered as so-called North Tartary, where bears walk in the streets. To show Russia as a country of high aviation and cosmic technologies is probably one of the most important missions, especially as many pilots will be able to participate in it. The staff of the group supposedly will be variable.
We offer an absolutely new type of active aviation tourism, when you can participate in a forthcoming event on your own.
Левый пошел на запуск. Итак. Все у нас включено, все включено, батарея нормально. Амбираж нормально.
Aircraft amphibian LA-8 is preparing for takeoff. It's going to be a very busy day. Aerovolga has designed these two-engine aircraft under international aviation regulations for aircraft of normal category Section 23 and today manufacture and sell them for export. A large capacity and serious performances of the aircraft takes it out beyond the family of aircraft of the weekend. LA-8 is designed for using it by private pilots and in state and commercial aviation.
Самолет Ла-8 может выпускаться в различных модификациях. И модификации предназначены для конкретного исполнения определенных...
The LA-8 aircraft can be produced in different modifications for performing different work. There is a monitoring version with two pilots, two operators and radio equipment on board. The aircraft can be on patrol up to 22 hours. At the same time, the crew is provided with dry closet, hot thermos and sleeping place. Thus, the crew can feel comfortable, and while on duty, there is a possibility to lie down and have a rest. There's a special version for firefighters. The aircraft can take on board 1 ton of water in the gliding mode and drop the water on the place of fire. The aircraft in this version has two seats for pilots and a tank inside the cabin. That is, firefighting is its only purpose. There's a business version with comfortable accommodation of one pilot, five passengers and luggage. This aircraft can be used for charter flights, corporate flights and so on. There is an ambulance version which allows transportation of two patients or casualties accompanied by one medical worker. There's a reanimation version in which the resuscitation equipment weighing up to 180 kilos is installed on the aircraft as standard equipment.
Unloading the picnic hamper from the nose baggage compartment is visual demonstration of LA-8 capabilities. For private pilots, the main advantage of the aircraft is undemanding to the quality of the runway. 400 meters of flat meadow is enough for takeoff and landing. Besides the new Czech engines LOM Praha in comparison with widespread Lycoming engines give significant saving. So the oil is replaced after 200 operating hours. It is possible to use motor gasoline having an octane number of 95 and fuel consumption is quite moderate. In flight with maximum load on the range of 1,500 km at the speed of 210 km per hour, the fuel consumption of LA-8 is only 60 liters per flight hour. Generally, it's amazing how small details are thought out in this aircraft. For example, this mirror on the float rack allows controlling the landing gear retraction and extension in addition to main system. The pilot's cockpit is very comfortable and equipped with modern instruments that allow performing flight at night and in bad weather conditions.
Автопилот, который мы применяем, это автопилот, разработанный нашим КБ.
The autopilot that we use is designed in our design department. The autopilot is axial with yaw damper. The autopilot allows to guide the aircraft along the route. It's connected with Garmin 650 and the instrument landing system. Thus, you can upload your route, including automatic approach, and take control at altitude of 50 meters in accordance with instructions.
Under the customer's request, the aircraft can be equipped with meteorological radar for detecting and mapping thunderstorms and even echo-sounding devices. The night vision system, additional landing lights, three-axis autopilot with yaw damper, and this is not a complete list. All major systems of LA-8 are duplicated or triplicated.
What is duplication? This is parallel connection of systems. Thus, it's either one system or the other. And complicated construction is when this system and that and yet another. As Chkalov said to Comrade Stalin, one engine is 100% risk, and four engines are 400%.
If the base modification of the aircraft is thought out so thoroughly, so the other versions can be designed as well. LA-8 is manufactured as in standard as in the North on tropical modifications. For North operation, the full de-icing system including airframe elements, heating and motor heaters, auxiliary power unit and ski set. Tropical version of LA-8 was delivered to the customer last year. It's harder plane without landing gear for operating in tropical marine conditions. But the most radical revision is LA-8RS. The purpose of the aircraft is flying around the world.
Aerovolga is a sponsor of the round-the-world flight 20,000 League Above the Sea. For this purpose, we have modified the serial aircraft LA-8, which we manufacture today, in RS version. The aircraft in this version has a more spacious cabin, increased seaworthiness, increased range up to 4,000 kilometers, with four crew members on board in order to get over the Atlantic or the Pacific.
Над Атлантическим и Тихим океаном.
20,000 league above the sea. Since the route passes over the water, it's manned sea leaks, 5,556 meters. 20,000 sea leaks equals 111,120 kilometers. It's almost three circles of the Earth's equator, 2.7 to be exact. Flying around the Earth almost three times would be a mixture of heroism and recklessness. And what does it mean to fly around the planet at least once?
It is certainly a challenge to fly around the world on boats. No one did so before, not only in Russia, but elsewhere in the world. Such a large group flying on hydroplanes above the water. There will be some legs where we'll have to fly above the water for 13 hours, 14 hours, or 15 hours without landing. Isn't it challenging?
The program of the round-the-world flight is designed for 3 months or 80 days, another theme of Jules Verne's novels. The flight will pass on all five continents. The participants will visit such places about which they only could read before and where no tour operators carry clients.
We are going to make a certain reality show about how all that will be happening. This will be collected in 20, 30, 40 episodes about people, about the flight, about the places where we will fly, and that is connected with them. This will be, I think, a very informative, interesting story. We are going to organize some webcast. Thus, relatives and friends of the participants will be able to visit the website of the flight any moment and watch what their son or brother or father or grandson are doing at that particular moment. We will try to organize all this in real time.
This is a challenge as well. With all the technical capabilities and budgets of the channels like Discovery, there was not anything similar even abroad. The cost of the possibility to show people what has never been done is really high. After all the secret of popularity, the TV series Deadliest Catch or Alaska Wingman is very simple. Millions of people have not given up their dream about real man deed. And who knows how many tired managers will leave offices for the sea and sky.
Если эти люди интересны, если у них есть что-то за
If these people are interesting, if they have something in their souls, if motivation of these people is clear-red, what they are doing here, each in fact checks himself. Not a technique, not staging, but those people about whom you tell, that is the main thing.
Вот это самое главное.
Of course, it will be weird to organize the round-the-world flight over the oceans of the planet only for a TV show. When all just say that in Russia everything is wrong, you want to do something real, alive. Fly 20,000 leagues above the sea is a way to show themselves and the world that Russia is capable for much.
Humanitarian, informational, scientific potential of round-the-world travel is certainly huge. We'll enhance the prestige of Russia, we'll raise the prestige of Samara region. We are showing to the world that Russia is not only able and can produce oil and gas, but it can produce such excellent aircraft virtually from scratch.
Мы демонстрируем, что технологии в России.
We demonstrate that technologies in Russia are new technologies, which only start to develop in the world, actually. Also, we show that we use this technology for some years. Our airframe is not metal or riveted, but it's made of composite materials.
Он выполнен из композитов, 100% композитных материалов.
The route of the flight is constantly exacted. Each new participant makes his offers, which immediately are reviewed by navigation group. Preparing of new stages of the flight has already enriched the organizers with knowledge about seas, oceans, and distant islands' geography, so that they can write textbooks. The thought of what awaits participants is simply breathtaking.
Ты занимаешься, наконец тебя выпускают самостоятельно в начале.
You are training. At last you're allowed to perform flight on your own, then you learn to perform route flight, then you learn to fly by instruments. These are the steps. That's why people fly and do not give up aviation, because this is the road without end. So with this company you go not only around the world, but somewhere in the park with tent and with great pleasure.
You can know.
Yelling in my ear, power in, carpe cold, climb out pitch, flaps to go, take it round the patch one more time again. But I know now he was showing me that just because the nose is pointing down, if it doesn't look right, give it one more try. You can always upside down.